Shalom, shalom, shalom. Good morning, good morning. Sorry for the delay, a little bit of technical issue. Good morning, beloved. Shalom. Today is a new month. Today is a wonderful day. God bless you for tuning with us this early morning. Hallelujah. God bless you. This is Fountain of Agape Mission Center, Agape Church, the church flowing with love, flowing with love, flowing with love, compassion. We are coming this morning in your house, into your houses, so that we can pray together the power of morning prayer. It is the power of morning prayer, beloved. The power of morning prayer. Hallelujah. So early in the morning, Jesus Christ was waking up according to the book of Mark, chapter 1, verse 35. And he was going to a solidarity place whereby he prayed throughout. Nobody knows how long. But the Bible is clearly say he prayed throughout. Hallelujah. Why? Because he wants to reverse the irreversible. He wants to reverse the irreversible. So this morning, this week, we're going to pray to reverse the irreversible that is blocking us not to move forward. Do you know God can go back to your foundation and begin to reverse things, make things to become new. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Thank you. Thank you for connecting. I'm Apostle Devin. I'm coming to your house this morning. I'm coming to your lunch this morning. Hallelujah. Share the link and connect. Receive the greeting from the senior pastor of Fountain of Agape Mission Center, Pastor Daniel. Hallelujah. We are working together. Hallelujah. So this week, you're going to receive him. Amen. You're going to be with him as well. So I'm starting the week with you. Hallelujah. The new month has begun. This is a new month with new expectation, new opportunity, new open doors in our life, in your life as well as in my life. Oh yes, in your life as well as in my life. So therefore, wake up and share the link to our beloved one. Share the link. Tell those that are still sleeping. Oh yeah, if you continue to sleep and you don't connect to morning prayer, beloved, that situation you are looking to change in your family will still there, be there. It will still be there looking at you as well. Oh yes, when you connect early in the morning, not only that you pray, hallelujah, but also you reverse the irreversible that is in your family, in your life, in your city. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Share the link, beloved. You share the link. Share the link. And then let us begin to pray. Invite many. All the contact on your phone. Invite them. Invite the contact on your phone. Invite them so that together we're going to pray. We're going to pray together. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We love you, Lord. We love you. We love you. We love you, King of Glory. We bless your holy name, Jesus. We bless your holy name. We give you glory. We give you honor. Your name is highly lifted up. Your name is highly lifted up this morning. Your name is highly lifted up. Your name alone is highly lifted up. We worship you, Lord. We worship you. For you are God. You are God. You are God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, King of Glory. Hallelujah. I began to thank God why we choose one or two songs to pray this morning, to sing, so that our spirit will be lifted up. Our spirit will be lifted up. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God. You are God. From beginning to the end, there's no place of argument. You are God all by yourself. You are God from beginning to the end. There's no place of argument. You are God all by yourself. You are God from beginning to the end. There's no place of argument. You are God all by yourself. Yes, he is God this morning. You are God from beginning to the end. There's no place of argument. You are God all by yourself. You are God, you are God. From beginning to the end, there's no place of argument. You are God all by yourself. You are God, you are God. From beginning to the end, there's no place of argument. You are God all by yourself. You are God from beginning to the end. There's no place of argument. You are God all by yourself. Thank you, Holy Spirit. He's God. He's God. Thank you, Lord. He is God. Really, He is God. Without Him, we can do nothing. Jesus declared it. Without me, you can do nothing. So this morning, we are coming to your houses. We are coming to pray together. Hallelujah. So wake up. Wake up from your slumber. Arise and pray. Jesus said, watch out. Watch out and pray. Hallelujah. Because the enemy is there to trick us, is there to make us not to wake up to connect, is there to bring disobedience so that we can be disobeying the Lord. We can be disobeying the Lord. Hallelujah. If you disobey your pastor indirectly, you are disobeying God. Hallelujah. But you may think you are disobeying your pastor. It's a man that you are seeing, but you don't know that you directly you are disobeying God with your attitude, with your way of behavior. Hallelujah. So this morning, and this thing is drawing curses upon our life. It's making us not to be stable with our Christian life. So this morning, beloved, thank God for Jesus that has come to reverse the irreversible. When we repent and come to Him, when we repent and come to Him, it will reverse the irreversible in our lives in the name of Jesus. So this week, the Power of Morning Prayer, we are talking about reversing the irreversible. The things that is standing there that doesn't want to move because of our attitude. If we apply the blood of Jesus, if we apply the word of God, if we know that Jesus has come, hallelujah, that we should not be under the curse anymore. And we are going to pray just like Jesus prayed. Hallelujah. Prayer is the only access of which make us to draw the heaven down, to draw the attention to God. I'm not talking praying with just our lips, but let the prayer be motivated from our heart. Be motivated from our heart in the name of Jesus Christ. Let it come right from our heart so that we can really pray this morning. As I said, the power of morning prayer, the power of morning prayer. There is power when you wake up early in the morning and began to pray, began to reverse the irreversible. Yes, began to reverse the irreversible. The things that has been holding you, holding us not to move forward. Hallelujah. Negativity, discouragement. Those are things that we have to reverse it this morning. In the name of Jesus Christ, we have to reverse the irreversible through prayer. Jesus, it was His custom. Oh yes, it was a lifestyle. A lifestyle. Let prayer be your lifestyle every morning, beloved. Let prayer be your lifestyle in the name of Jesus. So if you say 5 a.m. is too early for you to wake up, you love your bed more than anything. You love your duvet. When that trouble will knock at your door, that duvet will be hot. You will not stay there anymore. You'll be looking for a corner that you're going to pray. So therefore, this time, begin to train yourself so that you can be a friend. You have a fellowship, a relationship with God. Hallelujah. You have a relationship with God all the time so that you can have a relationship with your Father. He will not wait for you, to cry before He do what He says He will do. He will do it before you even cry. He will do it before you even cry. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. Rika sika rama seke ria baka saka ria maka sande. Rede ke rema soko ria baka sande. Rede bo soko ria baka saka. Yima sanda ria baka sika ria baka soko. Rika sika ria maka sanda. Rede bo seke Ezekiel. Connect, beloved. Share the link. Share the link. Share the link and share the link, beloved. I love morning prayer. Morning prayer, when you pray in the morning, you have direction of where to go. You got direction from the Holy Spirit. You got intimate with the Holy Spirit. He will direct you. He will direct you, instruct you, correct you, tell you, and heaven will be open. Your eyes will be open. You feel joy and peace because you have gone to your Father to have fellowship, relationship, communion with your Father. The Bible says Jesus God was coming every in the dawn and was meeting Adam in the garden, and they were having fellowship. Fellowship at the dawn. Hallelujah. So this morning, make it a lifestyle. Beloved, if you have not yet made this morning prayer your lifestyle, means you have another issue in your life. If you are in the ministry where they pray and you cannot make prayer your lifestyle, oh yes, I believe that by this prayer, most of all are delivered. We are set free. Hallelujah. Not to be slumber, not to be lukewarm. How karamasa karia basek. As I said, so when you make prayer a lifestyle, that is the essence of which we are praying early in the morning. We pray early in the morning to have direction, to have opening. So therefore, begin to thank God for your life, you that are connecting. Thank God for your life, reversing the irreversible. Yes, man of God, God bless you. Reversing the irreversible, the things that when we go through it this week, you will see that the word of God and prayer with children of God, the one that knows God, the righteous one, they reverse the irreversible in the name of Jesus Christ. They reverse the irreversible things that the enemy thought they were not gonna go away, but they reverse it through prayer. They reverse it through prayer. Jesus Himself reversed the irreversible through prayer. Hallelujah. True prayer. In the name of Jesus, we're going to pray. We're going to reverse irreversible this week. Irreversible. Starting from knowing what God has called you to do. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Listen to the book of Isaiah. A book of Isaiah Masaka. Those that are connecting with God. Those that take God to be their friend Jesus. Those that love God. That they love of God, they say the righteous one, hallelujah. They when they call, listen, in the book of Isaiah 65 verse 24, he said, and it shall come to pass, hallelujah, it shall come to pass that before they call, listen, this is a benefit of those that are connected, those that got fellowship with God every time, that God is their friend, God knows their problem, God knows their issue. He said, when that problem comes, it shall come to pass before that cry, before they call, I will answer thee. Hallelujah. This is a benefit. Before you say, what do I want? What is my issue? What am I going to do with this? God say, I will answer thee. This is what the Lord wants us to reverse, irreversible. He said, before you call, I will answer thee. Why? You are yet speaking, I will hear you. Maka sakara ina baka sokoria barada baraka seke reka sondora maseke ria maka seke redeke ria baka sanda pa. Beloved, underline the verse. Underline the verse, Isaiah 65. Isaiah chapter 65, verse 24. Hallelujah. He said, and it shall come to pass. It shall come to pass when that issue is there, when that challenges are coming, when that challenges are coming like waves, like wind, like wave. Hallelujah. When they're coming like waves, they want to catapult your boat. They want your boat to sink. The Bible says that before you call, you see the benefit of connecting with God, the benefit of being in a relationship with God. What we are having, most of us are having, is general blessing. I'm telling you, general blessing. Having job, going to have a little persecution in a job place, and then you see, you think you is general blessing. That those are general. But God wants to distinguish extinguish his righteous one. This morning, if you are righteous, that issue that has been there that nobody sees it, that issue, because you are in the fellowship and the relationship with God, before you call, before you cry, he will answer. He will answer. Hallelujah. Yeah, before you are still thinking, let me look for time to go and talk to my God, he will hear you. Hallelujah. So this week, we are going to reverse the irreversible in the name of Jesus. We are going to reverse it this week in our life. Yeah, hallelujah. We're going to turn it down. We're going to reverse it in the mighty name of Jesus. God, we go right back by began to sort out, hallelujah, destroy every foundation that has been holding us from our mother's side, our father's side, from ourselves. It will destroy it totally. Say, it shall come to pass. It shall come to pass when those challenges are coming like a wave. They are coming like a wave. He said, it shall come to pass that before thy call, this is for those that are diligently seeking the Lord, beloved. Diligently, knowing that in their deep mind, they are having fellowship. They meditate in the word of God. Through it, sleep in it. They meditate, they know, they trust in the God. They have confidence. For those that got confidence, I'm not talking about general prayer, beloved. If you are the one praying one day of your sleeping all throughout your life, you'll be sleeping, no fasting, no prayer, nothing. Oh yes, you're having general blessing, general, that God even give. He said, it makes his rain to fall upon the righteous and the unrighteous. That is general. When rain is coming down, he doesn't choose those that are wicked, that I'm not going to rain their crops, or those that it just make the sun to shine upon the righteous and general blessing. General, but they are blessing that when you, before you call, before you even open your mouth to speak, God will hear. That is the reversing the irreversible. They reverse the irreversible this morning to your life in the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. Began to pray, hallelujah, began to pray that Lord help me, Holy Spirit. Help me, Holy Spirit. I need you in my life. I need you in my life. Let my life be a fervent in prayer. Let my life, oh Lord, let my life, hallelujah. Let my life be, hallelujah. I say, let your life be the version of your Bible. Let them see your life and read the Bible. Let them see your life and come to Jesus. Let our life be glorified God in everything we are doing, in the blessing the Lord is giving us. Let our life say, before you call, we answer thee. Before you call, there is blessing to be connected with God, beloved. You may be thinking, this woman is worrying us every morning at 5 a.m., but you don't know. You are missing a lot of blessing. You are missing. We are missing a lot. Oh, yes, early in the morning, I want to go to Jesus. Early in the morning, I want to talk to Jesus. Early in the morning, I want to be in the relationship with my Jesus. Early in the morning, I want to have fellowship with my Jesus. I want to have my breakfast with my Jesus. Early in the morning, I want to have my breakfast. Yes, Lord, thank you. It is a grace, a divine grace to wake up early in the morning, beloved. It's not by might, it's not by power, but it's by the Spirit of the living God, says the Lord. Hallelujah, glory. Early in the morning, I want to have my fellowship with my Jesus, fellowship with Jesus, relationship with Jesus. When you build your relationship with someone, when the person knows who you are, hallelujah, he knows what you are going through, he will identify himself. Before you call, he will answer you. Say, Lord, answer me. He said, before you call, it means that you don't even need to talk too much. You don't even need to, he knows the problem. But because you are his friend, he don't want you to go through that trouble alone. He's going ahead, hallelujah, going ahead, paving the way. So today, in the name of Jesus, this week you're gonna reverse everything, starting from yourself. Say, Lord, I want to be on fire for you. I want to be on fire for you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, use me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, King of Glory. Rika sakara masondo ria baka sanda. Yekere debo sikarina baka rede debo sokore baba baba. Yekere na basokora masanda rede debo. Ria marana rabaka seke. I pray for someone today you are seeing better. I pray for you today that you, this Holy Spirit, wherever you are listening, hallelujah, pray that as you are navigating your Facebook, you will see us and you will stop. As you are navigating your Facebook, that the Holy Spirit will make you to stop so that you can hear this word this morning in the name of Jesus. You can hear this word this morning in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your wonderful word this morning that you told us before we call, you will hear us. Before you call, you will look at somebody reverse the situation and he stopped and reversed it. Hallelujah. The Bible says, Elias. The book of James, chapter 5, verse 17. Elias was a man subject to passion as we are. He was a man like you and I. And he prayed earnestly. This is talking of King the first King chapter 17 and chapter 18. You will see when Elias stopped the rain and he prayed again and the rain fell. Yes, that is the power of the prayer. The power of prayer. The power means God is the one, divine power of God, walking in our life, walking in your life when you connect with him. When you know who he is, when you know that he is your God. The Bible says Elias was a man subject like passion as we are, and he prayed earnestly. Beloved, he engaged in prayer with his soul, spirit, and body. He don't just pray only with the mouth. He engaged earnestly from the heart. He prayed earnestly that it might not rain, and it rained not on the earth by the space of 3 years and 6 months. And he prayed again. He reversed the situation. When the rain did not come, he prayed again. Araka sakaria baka solo rena baka seke, and heavens gave rain, and the earth brought forth her fruit. When hakasaka, go to the book of 1 Kings chapter 17 and 18 and read. You will see the history. You see the story. What makes Elias to pray that the rain should not fall? You see the power that the Lord has given you and I. We have got power in the word of God. Hallelujah. There's power in the word of God. There is power. We can pray and stop, and we can pray and bring. We can pray and stop, and we can pray and bring. We can pray and reverse. Hallelujah. We can pray and stop any evil, anything that wants to interfere with our life. God has given you and I that power. Elias was a man subject to like a passion like you and I. He was not a spirit. He was not an angel. He was a man like you and I. But because he was having relationship with God, he was having fellowship. That character is still in you because you don't have fellowship with God. That way you are behaving, so most of us are behaving, is because we have not yet gone into the intimacy with the Holy Spirit to say, but this morning, I reverse that attitude. I reverse that disobedience. I reverse it and bring it to obedience. That negativity, I reverse it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh yes. That business that is not moving, it will begin to move. Hallelujah. That business that is not moving, that issue that is not standing, hallelujah, will begin to receive the word of God this morning. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, receive. It was a man's subject. He prayed earnestly. Hallelujah. Another verse, fervently. He prayed earnestly. It means he engaged his body, soul, and his spirit in that prayer. And he prayed again. Oh, yes. After 3.5 years, yes, they saw the power of God, that the man of God has spoken, that the rain will not fall into this place. Rain will not fall. And he saw, he went back to God. He prayed again. Hallelujah. Karema, Sandaria, Bakasoko, Redeke, Reba, Sakarama, Sandaria. The power of morning prayer. Prayer must be. Oh, some people take prayer like that. They take prayer when they feel like emotion, when they feel like they pray. Your prayer must be as you are breathing. If God stop that breathing, you are dead. When a Christian doesn't pray, it's a dead Christian. It's a person that is dead. He's walking, but he's dead. Oh, my sakare, my sin. You think you are a Christian, you are born again. You are dead. If you don't pray, if you don't read the Bible, if you are not praying, because this breath we are breathing, prayer is the breathing. When you are breathing, if you stop breathing today, you will die. So if you stop praying, you're gonna die. You are dead already. Masake. So I will not stop praying. I'm not gonna stop praying, because the Bible says it shall come to pass. Before I call, he will answer me, because I build my relationship with God. He knows me more than what I know myself. He knows what I'm going through. So therefore, before I call, he will answer me. Before I even say a word, he hears me. He said, my daughter, my son, do not worry. I'm in this business with you. So I pray this morning that every situation that has been there, that you think God is not seeing, as we pray this morning, the power of morning prayer, we are reversing that thing. Hallelujah. Reversing the irreversible. It shall be reversed this morning in the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, glory be to God. Thank you, Father. Thank you, King of Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are God from beginning to the end. There's no place of argument. You are God all by yourself. And you are God from beginning to the end. There's no place of argument. You are God all by yourself. You are God from beginning to the end. There's no place of argument. You are God all by yourself. You are God, you are God. From beginning to the end. There's no place of argument. You are God all by yourself. We are serving the living God. We are serving the creator of heaven and earth, the one that created everything, the Alpha and Omega. He's able to reverse the irreversible. He's able to bring that things that is dead, hallelujah, that has been buried back to life. He's able to restore. There is no place of argument in the name of Jesus. No God can do what your God and my God is doing this time. No God can do it. He's reversing the irreversible this week. He's going to do it not only this week, forever and ever. He still remains God, the Alpha and Omega. That's the God you are serving. That's the God I'm serving. He said, before you call, hallelujah, he will answer. So therefore, it's not talking for common Christians. This is talking for those that know who the God is, that there's no place of argument. It's not talking for normal Christians. Before you go into this deep, you have to be supernatural in the spirit, so that when you call, because your heart is needed with him, your network with him will be flowing all the time, because he knows that, hallelujah, that my child, my daughter, my son need me at this time, because he's omnipresent, all powerful. Beloved, you need to know who your God is. You don't just need to talk it, you have to put it in practice. You have to live with it. It need to be a lifestyle. Hallelujah, glory be to God. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Let prayer be my lifestyle. Let prayer be as I'm breathing. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Listen. Let's go. Makasakaria bakasondo reba sikaraba. Yekeredebo sokorama sandaredebo. Rekaraba sekeria bakasondo reba sekeriaba. Yekeredebo sokorama sandaredaba sekeredaba. Yenda karanaba sandaredebobo. Began to pray. If you have not get into that level life that, oh, you say, I'm going to walk with Jesus. I'm going more. Hallelujah. I'm in a journey with God in the name of Jesus. He will never leave me, will never forsake me. In the mighty name of Jesus. Reka sakara masondo reda baka seke reba sandare debo. Reke reke seke rima sandari abaka sandare debo. Reke reda baba baba baba. Roma soko raba seke reda baba baba. Yeke rena masara ina baka sakare debo. Roboko soko rama sandare debo. Reke rena baka soko raba seke rea baka sandare debo. Ina karama sakari abaka sakare daba. Ina ranaba. Pray that prayer. Pray. Hallelujah. Say, God, reverse my irreversible this morning. Reverse my irreversible this morning. In the mighty name of Jesus, when I call unto you, answer me. When I call you, answer me. When I call you, answer me. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Have your way this morning, Lord. Have your way. Have your way. Have your way. In the mighty name of Jesus, yika sakara masanda rina maraba sakara daba seke yika raba baba baba sikara masanda yika sikaria baka sakara baba. Jesus, no matter, I am the resurrection. I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, he will reverse the irreversible. I am the resurrection and the life. And he demonstrated by the power of God. Lazarus, I was dead and he was in the tomb for 4 days. And Jesus, hallelujah, knew that they were calling for him. He said, for the glory of God to be manifest, to be manifest. Jesus said, take away the stone. Jesus, therefore, again crowning in himself. Let me tell you, crowning in himself. In the book of John chapter 11, I'm reading the book of John chapter 11. We all know that story, but we don't know how to put it in practice in our life. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. Anything that is dead, it will come to life. It will come to life. God will color your life. Your life will be colorful this week. Your life will be colorful. My life will be colorful in the mighty name of Jesus. Anything that is dead this morning, is dead in your life, your talent, your potential. This morning, this week, I've come to declare and decree that Jesus will bring it to life. He said, I am the resurrection and the life. Hallelujah. That is your God. That is the God we are serving. We are serving the God that is alive. I am the resurrection and the life. It told matter that. Matter was complaining. He said, how am I going to do? This situation is, hallelujah, who can reverse it? Who can? It's irreversible. Matter look at the situation. He look at the brother that is dead. He's thinking. That problem, that issue may be stinking. Matter say it is stinking. Lord, you cannot go. It's 4 days now they bury Lazarus. It is stinking. That issue has been stinking. Oh, you say no one can, hallelujah, reverse it. It is irreversible. But I brought the news, good news for you this morning. I'm bringing the good news this morning to your room, to your that situation, that issue that you think is irreversible, is going to be reversed this morning. In the mighty name of Jesus, God will reverse it for your good. He will reverse it for your good this morning. That sickness, that disease, he will reverse it, hallelujah. That affliction, he will reverse it this morning. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, it's irreversible, Lord. Lazarus is dead since. Nobody can bring him to life anymore. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. I am the resurrection. Hallelujah. I am present tense. I am the resurrection and the life. Jesus says so. I am the resurrection and the life. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Thank you, Holy Spirit. We are serving a God that is alive. A God that is alive. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. The Jews then were with her in the house and comforted. But when Mary was come where Jesus was and saw him, she fell down at her knees, saying unto her, Lord, if thou hast been here, God is omnipresent. He's always there when we are going to. But because we don't know his power, we think that it's too late for him to act. I've come with the good news this morning that it is not too late. It is not too late. So don't give up. It's not too late. That situation, that issue, that problem, that sickness, that infirmity, that disease gonna be reversed this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. God is reversing this morning in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Say, Lord, reverse my problem. Hallelujah. That problem will be irreversible. But God is in your business. Jesus is in that business. Jesus is in that business. Jesus is in that business. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. He is in that business, beloved. Say, Lord, God is in my business. Whatever thing I'm going through, He is in the business. He will reverse the irreversible. He's going to reverse the irreversible. That financially, in your career, in your studies, in your marriage, in everything, that child, that son, that daughter, that you think she's on drug, she's drug addict, she's alcoholic, that problem that wants to make you to commit suicide, that you think is irreversible, this morning God is reversing it. In the name of Jesus, the Lord is reversing that situation. Only believe. Believe that I am the resurrection and the life. Believe that there is nothing too hard for me this morning to do. There is nothing too hard for me to do in your life. Believe that business. You say, oh, that business is not going forward. I don't know what to do. That business is still there. It's not going forward. Let me tell you, God is there to go back and reverse everything. He's bringing it normal to your favor, to my favor, in the mighty name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus said there, verse 44, he said, then they took away the stone from the place where the dead was laid. Something blocking. Something, that stone that they put, blocking. That stone blocking you, blocking the entrance, blocking the gate that you should not go. Jesus said they took away. They took it away. That stone, I take it away this morning. I remove it from your way. In the name of Jesus, it is a blockage. It's a barrier for you not to penetrate. So this morning, hallelujah, I'm praying in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, let that stone be removed. Let that stone be removed in the name of Jesus so that you can come out alive. You can come out alive. You are coming out alive. Say, I'm coming out. I am coming out in the name of Jesus. I'm coming out. I am coming out alive. He said they took the stone from the place where the dead was laid. So they were not sure that this is why they just put a stone, put big stone on the grave. Say, yes, we are finished with you. No more seeing you anymore. We have finished with you. You are dead and you are gone. Beloved, that's how many people, most people, many people are saying into your business, into your life, that your own is finished, your business is finished, your ministry is finished, nothing will work anymore, you are good for nothing. But Jesus is saying this morning, hallelujah, this morning, and Jesus lifted up his eyes, first of all, lifted up his eyes and do what? And said, Father, I thank thee, Makasakaria Basako. Always lift up his eyes and pray and thank God. Thankfulness, gratefulness. He didn't look at the situation that he began to grumble. He began to complain, but he thanked God. Oh, you may think, why is he thanking God? Somebody is dead. He's thanking God. Marika Saka. That's where the power comes. When the situation is there, when the challenges is there, you lift up your eyes to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the maker of the heaven and earth, and you began to thank him because that challenges, that situation is for his glory. It's for his glory. He first of all thanked the Father. He said, Father, I thank thee for thou hast heard me. He didn't even pray anything. That's why Isaiah 65 verse 24 comes to pass. He said, before you call, before you call, I will answer thee. Because he was having relationship with his Father all time. Fellowship every time. It was his lifestyle. It was his lifestyle, the Bible says. That all the time he was going out, he was taking himself among the crowd. You still remain in the crowd. All the time you are in the crowd. If this one doesn't go to church, I will not go. If my husband doesn't wake up, I will not wake up. If my wife doesn't wake up, you still be in the crowd. That situation is entangling you. But now I'm bringing a good news to you this morning that the Lord Almighty say, thank God because you have heard me. Come out from that. That thing is, God is about to reverse it for good in your life. In the mighty name of Jesus, he's about to reverse it for good. He said, thank thee before you, your father, I thank thee that thou has heard me. He didn't even pray. So it means he was in his spirit. He was having a relationship, and as he was praying in his spirit, he already had the answer. He knew that God has heard him, beloved. When the Lord answers you, you will feel it in your spirit. When that situation, that challenge, you have seen a breakthrough, you will feel it in your spirit. Your spirit will say, yes, it is done. It is okay. God has answered you because your heart is in the relationship with God. Say, thank God, thank the Father. The answer, and I knew that that hears me. Isaiah 65:24. I knew that that here it brings this to pass, beloved. We are still remaining in that position because we don't know where to start and where to end, and that's why we stay there. We want to approve for men. This is not connection of men, it's the prayer, the relationship with God that makes us, that will make you and I to be connected with those that God wants you to be connected with. You see, yes, you see, now I knew that that hears me always. That hears me always. God will hear us always when we are connected with him. In the mighty name of Jesus, that hears me always. Beloved, hallelujah. It takes time. It takes those that are in the spirit, those that are connected with God. I say, you may have general blessing. You think you are blessed. No. General blessing. Oh, that general blessing happened to everyone. It happened to even unbelievers and believers. But there are some blessing that it takes fervent people, righteous one. Hallelujah. For God to release that blessing. And Jesus says, I know that they are hearing me. Always. Not for some time. Always. But because of the people we stand by, I said that they may believe that that has sent me for the glory. That has sent me. And when thou hast spoken, he cried with loud voice, Lazarus, come out. Lazarus, come out. Hallelujah. Come out. Yekasaka, come out. That situation that is holding, that challenging, putting you in the grave. This morning, I say, come out. Come out. Come out in the name of Jesus. He in the name, and the he that was dead came forth. He came forth. He came forth. Beloved, you are serving a living God. You're serving a living God. A God that is a God. He knows the purpose of our life. He knows why he created me. He created you. He knows why we are living. So we just need to be connected with him and do what he says. Be obedient to his word. Jesus was obedient to his father. He could have said, yes, father, I know. That's why he should say, yes, father, I know that thou hearest me. That hearest me. That hearest me. And that will answer. I know that though, I thank thee because that hears me. You have heard me. And when you hear me always. Not first, not now. Always. Hallelujah. Always. Jesus, thank you, Holy Spirit. I reverse that situation that has put you in the grave for so long. They have the evil foundation from the father, mother's side on the father's side that has put you in the grave. No, beloved, because of the tradition, a lot of us, most of us, have been born in a tradition, in native doctors and everything. And if you don't take yourself with violence, you remain there doing religion, thinking you're serving God. You remain there doing religion, doing things that just serve God when you want, when you like. Do the things that you want. That is evil. You don't do what you want when you are in the Lord. You do what God tells you to do. You do what God says you should do. Hallelujah. So his name will be glorified. So therefore, to go into this realm of the spirit, to begin to call out the things that are not as if they were, you need to be connected with God. He said, call those things that are not as if they were. Those are the people that their language have changed, the way they speak have changed. Hallelujah. Our hearts have changed. Our heart is full with joy. It's full with meditation of the word of God, the power of God. Say the righteous, hallelujah, will call unto the Lord and God will hear them. Say the righteous, not the Christian, the righteous, they are right, the righteous, hallelujah. When they call to the Lord, when they are in affliction, they call. This is the thing. We are reversing Makasika Rada by the irreversible this week. The irreversible. This thing that have been standing, I pray for your business this morning. I pray for your business. That business that have not been moving. Hallelujah. I pray that the Lord Almighty, everything that has been blocking, that stone that they've put, that the enemy have come to put the stone of discouragement, the stone of negativity. He has blocked the way with so many things. This morning, I'm removing that stone. That stone is, I'm taking off the stone in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the angels of God, I say, Lord, release your angels to remove that stone that is standing on our way. Take away that stone in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Began to walk the way. Began to do the things of God. Began to do the things you didn't do. Beloved, I say they are common blessing. Common blessing. But they are blessing that is for the righteous. The righteous. They say before, you don't even need to cry too much, many of us. We actually, we cry, we complain, we cry, we complain. But we don't do the right thing. We are not doing the right thing. Complaining, crying, complaining. Oh, this thing is not working. I'm going through a low. I'm going, hey, child of God. Crying all the time from January to December, complaining and crying. Do you know who your God is? Your God is, hallelujah. He's omnipresent, omniscient, all-powerful. He is all-powerful. He knows your problem, mother. He said, before the righteous cry, before he call, he will hear, he will answer. He will answer. Hallelujah. Began to think, why is it situation being like this all the time? I need to do something with my spiritual life. I need to do something with my spiritual life in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Jesus said, Father, yes, this prayer, Father, I thank thee that thou heard me. And I knew that thou always hear me. You hear me always. Always. Hallelujah. Always. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. And my God hears me always. My God hears me always. Oh, yes, he is hearing me always. I will not give up. Oh, because he hears me. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Say, build your relationship with your God. Starting by this morning prayer. Build your relationship with God. Yes. Don't do what please you. Kill your flesh. Crucify your flesh. Take your flesh to the cross. Crucify your flesh. I'm going to wake up early in the morning. I'm going to join this morning prayer. My life needs to change. Hallelujah. My life needs to change because I'm serving a God that is the resurrection and the life. He said, I am. So Jesus' name is resurrection. I am resurrection. When they ask you to present yourself, you will say, I am this. I am that thing. See, Jesus said, I am. He presented himself. He introduced himself that I am the resurrection. Hallelujah. Any dead things that is dead in my life, resurrection will bring it to life in the name of Jesus. So this morning, beloved, anything that is dead will come to life. Your mindset, oh yes, your way of doing things to God, it will come to life. Your prayer life is death. Your meditation life is death. Your devotion life is death. Jesus is bringing it to life. He has been buried. You bury it and put a stone yourself on it. So this morning I've come to release the power of the resurrection, the power of restoration, that prayer life will begin to receive fire. You began to move in the realm of the spirit this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. So when you speak, before you speak, it will answer. Before you even call, hallelujah, carida baka seke, you will renew. I renew my relationship with God. I'm renewing my relationship with God this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, listen, hallelujah, I am the resurrection. You will see it in Ezekiel chapter 37. Ezekiel chapter 37, that's why it comes to pass. He said, the hand of the Lord was upon me, and he carried me out of the spirit, and he sent me down in the midst of the valley, which was full with dry bones. Oh, my Sarah, this is extraordinary. Extraordinary power. Supernatural divine power of God. Oh, in the valley of dry bones. We are in the valley where there are dry bones. Oh, Christians are there, but they don't do what God is doing. Oh, we say we are born again, but we are disobedient. Oh, we are in that place of dry bones that we want to please our flesh. We want to please our emotion. We want to please. We are centered. We are in that valley of dry bones. But listen, one person was righteous. Ezekiel was righteous, and he caused me to pass by them round out, and behold, there were very many in the open valley, and lo, they were very dry. When you are drunk, Morocco, Soko, Redeboka, Sakaria, Bakasade, when you say you are dry, your mindset is not about God. You come to church, but your spirit is not there. You just come, you are dry. The way you behave, the way you act, you are so dry. You are not excited. You are not happy. You cannot appreciate. You are dry. There's nothing that motivates you, nothing that makes you happy. The Bible says the Messiah went through it. He saw that they were dry, 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 dry. So this morning, I've come to release the power that will make you, hallelujah, the power to bring resurrection, to bring life, to bring tendon, to bring flesh bones in you. In the name of Jesus, dry, dry. A lady says to you in our church, say, why is it the place is too quiet? Cool, with so powerful preaching, nobody is even excited. It takes individual to be excited. It's not the word of God is not there to push you. You yourself need to be excited. You need to know your God. Yes, it takes another person to come and speak it. He said unto me, son of man, Can these bones live in the valley of dry bones? Can these bones live? Oh yes, some of our churches are the valley of dry bones. You see, many people, they are dry. So I've come with the good news this morning that you are not dry. I say, I am coming out. I'm coming out. Again, he said unto me, prophesy. Prophesy upon these bones and say unto, oh, dry bones, hear the word of God this morning. Hear the word of God. If you are listening to me, dry bones, hear the word of God. Hear the word of God, not the word of Ezekiel. Hear the word of God, you that are listening, or after or now. Hear the word of God. Hear the word of God. Hallelujah. Behold, cause breath unto enter into them. Let the breath of life enter into you this morning so that you may live. Let the breath of God enter into you this morning so that you shall live in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Immediately say so. They be receiving. They receive it. I prophesy as I was commanded. Some of us, we prophesy out of the word of God. And we have not even commanded. God didn't say we should say something. We began to say it to please the people. To please the people, because that is what they want to hear. I pray for those people this morning. Hallelujah. That you should repent. Speak what as God has commanded. Speak the word that God has commanded you to speak. Don't go out. Don't come in. Go speak it. Hallelujah. We have to be speaking what God. And when we speak what the Lord has commanded us to speak, the name of the Lord will be glorified. The dry bones will receive. Hallelujah. They will receive life again. They will receive life again. But when we speak to please a person, they will never change. They will still be waiting for that word that you are speaking. Hallelujah. To speak them. And it will never come to pass, because it's not God that has commanded that word to be spoken that time. God, he said, I speak as God has commanded Rekasaka rama sende re masoko ye karaya baka soko re baka sande re karia baka sondo re maseke re karaba sakaria baka seke re masanda rama seke re debo soko re maka seke re narana maraba raba 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 ye kere la basakara baseke. I release the spirit of God, the spirit of prayer upon your life this morning in the name of Jesus. Receive life. Receive life. I reverse every irreversible situation in your life this morning. I reverse it in the name of Jesus. I command the money to be in your favor. I command the money to be in your favor. Let that door that has been closed, Maramba Saka, Ria Baka Saka, begin to receive the word of God. Be open, divinely open in the name of Jesus. Let your eyes be divinely open to see what the Lord is doing in this season, in this time, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, thank you, King of Glory. Thank you, Everlasting Father. Thank you, Everlasting Father. Thank you, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Your name is highly lifted up. Your name is highly lifted up. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, thank you, Holy Spirit. We bless you, we worship you. Say, I'm set free. I have been set free from lukewarmness. I have been set free from prayerlessness. My life is coming back again. Hallelujah. I've received life. I've received life. Every dead thing in my life, hallelujah, is coming back. Restored. It has been restored. My prayer life is being restored. My prayer life is being restored. My devotion life is being restored. In the name of Jesus Christ. Oh yeah, Jesus said, call him out. Lazarus, receive life. These dry bones, they receive life. So any dry bones, salamasaka, things that is not fruitful in your life, the area of your life that is not fruitful, that's not glorifying God, let begin to receive life. Let him begin saying, you hear me all the time. Lord, you hear us all the time. Let him, let's say, that area of my life that is not fruitful. Is it your career? Is it your study? Is it your business? Is it your marriage? Is it whatever thing that is dead? Let him begin to receive life. Let him begin to be fruitful in the name of Jesus. Father, go back right to my foundation. Rebuild it. My Christian life foundation. Hallelujah. Rebuild it. Let me, hallelujah, begin to be fruitful this morning in the name of Jesus. Before I speak, let my relationship with God be renewed, be restored. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Reversing the irreversible. Oh yes, we'll go through it. You will see a lot of things that you have got power to reverse it. You see, I spoke as I was commanded by God. I spoke as I was commanded by God. And I speak the word of God as I was commanded. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. We are speaking things that God never said. Just because we want crowd, we want to please people. And their life will never change. A Christian that is life never change. You can be in the crowd, you can never change. Here come, just because we want to please them. We'll be speaking the things that they want to hear. And we are bearing them more and more. Bearing them more and more after we put the stone. But this morning, I come to say, hear the word of God. Don't hear the word of anyone. Hear the word of God, what God has spoken. It will enter, it will pass through man to speak it. But your spirit will say, yes, this is what the Lord has spoken. Hallelujah, glory be to God. Walking in the power of the Holy Spirit, having full relationship with God. I pray that this morning you have got full relationship with God. Full relationship. Your business will prosper this morning. Hallelujah. As you began to walk into the right position, you began to do what God has asked you to do. You began to walk according to the power of the Holy Spirit. You began to walk and with obedience. Hallelujah. You began to reap the fruit of obedience. You will reap the fruit of obedience. Hallelujah. The Bible says in Galatians chapter 6 verse 7, that do not be deceived. God is not mocked. Whatever man can will sow, he's going to reap. Hallelujah. If you sow obedient, you will reap obedient. If you sow disobedient, you will reap disobedient. Along the line, how people began also to disobey you. If you sow lack of concern, you will reap it. Masakaria baka sana redebo soko. If you sow love, you will reap love. If you sow compassion, you will reap compassion. So this morning, I've come to release the power of God. So you began to do what Jesus was doing. Began to have compassion. Began to have concern. Began to have concern. Hallelujah. In people's business. Began to have concern. Have compassion. So that life will come back to normal. Life will come back again. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. I command the money this morning. That your money will be colorful. Your money will be colorful. Wherever you go, Masaka, the supernatural favor of God will accompany. The grace of God will accompany. In the name of Jesus. Haka senda reda basaka ria baka sondore. Reke rede deboko soko ria. But say my money will be colorful. Oh yes, my money will be colorful. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. My money will be colorful. In the name of Jesus. Yes, I will not leave the presence of God until he answer me. Oh, I will be in full relationship with God. I will meditate the word of God. I will devote myself to know him more and more. To know him deeper. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you for connecting. God bless you all. If those are going to come, share it. Share the video. You can go to our YouTube. Hallelujah. And you can follow us up in YouTube, Twitter. Share everything. And we are starting this morning prayer for Monday to Friday. It is our lifestyle, beloved, to pray. It's our lifestyle for Monday to Friday. So if the Holy Spirit, I know, not if, the Holy Spirit wants you to connect with us all the time, but say, I'm not going to be disobedient to the power of God. Hallelujah. I'm not going to be, especially when you are the member of Fountain of Agape Mission and you decided not to be connected just because you want to be disobedient. Beloved, you are missing the Lord. You're missing your blessing because the devil wants you to miss. He wants you to miss. Hallelujah. Glory. Thank you. Thank you, my brother. God bless you. My brother. Is connecting. Thank you. So this morning we thank God for this morning as our morning prayer. So we're gonna round up this morning. Hallelujah. Thank God. So tomorrow morning we're gonna be here as well. We're gonna be here to pray. Hallelujah. So share the link and also share the video. If you are still sleeping, no worry. I'm gonna share the video to all of us. I'm gonna put it in our forum so that you can share, because it's too early for some of us, or maybe some of us are going to work, or some of us are coming back from work. Hallelujah. So therefore it's too early, but therefore Jesus was waking up very early. Hallelujah. God bless you, my junior brother. God bless you for connecting. Hallelujah. God bless you. To be late is not to be absent. We are always here every morning and to pray for our family, pray for our people, our wife and husband, our children. So we thank God for today again. We don't want to take it for granted. We are thanking God for what he's doing in our family, for what he's doing in our community. We are thanking God and we pray for those that are sick. Still, the COVID-19 is still spreading mightily. Take care of yourself. Take care of yourself. Take care of yourself. If it takes you to put the mask, put the mask. Put it where you are going for shopping. Really, it is not a joke. Many people are being positive. Even though the lift down has been lifted everywhere, the rate is going high and high. So therefore, we advise you to take good care of yourself as you go out. In the name of Jesus Christ, keep on doing the test. If you have not done the vaccine, go to the nearby pop-in and do your vaccine, beloved. Take your vaccine. Be obedient to the government and God is going to bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank God. We thank God. God bless you and we love you all and stay blessed. Yes, dear brother, God bless you and greet everyone. Greet all the family. We love you. Bye-bye. God bless you. We are almost at the end. Thank you. Let us share the grace. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now. And surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life. And we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Jesus loves you. If you have not yet received Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, this is the time. This is the moment. Receive him. He's the one that will take us to eternal life, beloved. After this life is death, and where are we going to spend our eternity? We need to know Jesus and receive him and believe in him and confess with our mouth and believe in our heart, and he will give us eternal life. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. assigned to, and he looked for a Bible and began to read the Bible. If there's any living church, a Bible teaching church, go there so that you can study the Word of God. Study the Word of God and know the purpose of God in your life. Hallelujah. Glory be to God in the mighty name of Jesus. God did not call us just to come and live a life helplessly. He wants us to have connection with Him. And that is our passion. That's our desire. So that we can train disciples in this end time. So that they will know God. So God bless you for connecting. We thank God for your life. And know that tomorrow morning is our Bible. Is a prayer of the morning. The power of prayer in the morning. And in the evening, we are in the church. We are in our church premises for the Bible studies tomorrow. So don't stay at home. Say the lockdown is still there. No, the lockdown has been lifted since like the first of this month. So we are now going back to church to study the Word of God. So come with us. Join us. Hallelujah. Don't stay at home. Join us in the church so that we can study the Word of God together. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Bye-bye. God bless you. Bye. See you.